Hey everybody, it's been a little while and I apologize for that, but we are doing a video today on how to add a logo to your truck without making a paint job for it. Going to be using an existing hookup or an existing model and then adding that logo to the model that you would normally have on your truck to allow you to kind of manipulate that and then change whatever paint job that you would like to have, but still have that logo or that text on the door or something like that available to you to have on your truck at any time, no matter what paint job you're using. So let's take a look and see what we can do to make this work for us. All right, so here we are in our familiar place, which is Blender, of course. I've created a test base path up here. We're going to be using the W900. I just called it W900 door logo. What we're going to do here is we're going to import this using ConverterPix wrapper. We got to find the base here. Okay, so we need to find archives, so we're going to have to look for the base, which is going to be, in my case, over in D. Did I even add it? Oh, I did not. So we can find that in my games folder. We got the base. We also have to select the Kenworth W900. So we're going to go down to vehicle, truck, Kenworth, truck. You always want to import the truck to allow yourself to check fitment of what you're adding. So in this case, we want to see, you know, where this actually fits on the sides. So let's clear out that. So right now we can see the door, and obviously it's going to change depending on the side, because this one has a opening for the glass. And now what we're going to want to do is find approximately the center of the door, and you can do this multiple different ways, but in this case we're going to use the cursor. So now I'm going to add a mesh plane, and it's going to be on its side, so you're going to want to rotate it. So let's look and see which way the normals are facing. And we can do that by going into here, face orientation. So the blue is the face orientation out. So when we rotate this using the y-axis, we're going to want to do 90. Nope, we're going to want to do negative 90. Hey, now. Rotate negative 90. Why? Enter. Now, obviously, the door is slanted in a certain way, so we're also going to have to rotate around Z and then move it, grab an X, like so. Now we're going to want to shrink it so it fits on the door. We also want to make sure that it's big enough and it's not off the door too far. So it looks like right now it is off the door a little too far. So we're going to grab it again and do an X and move it until it starts disappearing. Okay. So that looks okay. We could probably grab it and bring it forward in the Y and then grab it in the Z and then check where it is. We have to move it again, grab X. Okay, it might be too far in, grab X. There we go. Okay, so I think that's pretty good. Now, I've made an image quickly. We can turn this off now. Now, I've made an image already, and so we just need to assign the image to this. So we'll call this door logo. We're going to check the shader presets, probably use a diff spec for this. That way we can use the decal over, add vertex colors. Mapping is right now UV map. And then we're going to find our picture. In this case, we'll have to go into the file editor here. Did I put it in pictures? Okay, copy. And then we're going to go into our mods and go to the test mod, which is here, and then door logo. And then we're going to put it under vehicle truck Kenworth 900 right under here. We don't have to do anything special to it. You can add it in a different folder if you like, but I'm just going to put it in the base folder. This is Guido and Sons. So let's move this out of the way. And then we can find our TGA file. So now, if I do this, it's showing up black, right? So, oh, it's actually rotated. So what we need to do is go to the editor and rotate this 90 degrees. And we'll see where we are now. Oh, upside down. Okay. So let's do rotate 180. There we go. And now on the logo, we should be able to go back here now and do decal over. Let's get rid of the shadows. So there you go. So now J. Guido and Sons Logistics Site Work, Cape Cod, Massachusetts. So you can have that on any one of your trucks and whatever paint job you desire. And so now let's go into the UV editing. You can change how big it looks. If I shrink this, it will get bigger on the door. So now it'll go like that. So now let's take this and we will duplicate it and rotate it about the Z axis 180 degrees. And then we'll grab it and bring it to the other side. We're going to have to do some more fudging around with this guy because it's going to be over the window and that's going to look a little silly. So let's rotate Z, grab X, grab Y, grab X, grab Z, grab Y, then let's check our rotation here. We might be able to rotate a little bit more. So it's like that. So if you want, you could take this one and move it back a little bit so it kind of lines up. And then grab X. Let's make sure it's not too far off the body. Also, don't forget, we just got these new hats in on the fourth wall site for my new merch store. So you can pick up hats, a couple of different types. Actually, there's one with a white front and a black logo. There's the black with the white logo. There's a sweatshirt. And yeah, there's a couple of things on there right now. I'm going to be adding more as time goes on. And these guys have proven to be a good choice for me, and I'm happy to have them as my partner doing merch. So the hats have come out fantastic. So make sure you go check that out. The link will be in the description below if you'd like to grab some hats or a sweatshirt. So I have to go a little bit over that. Oops. Okay. So now we've got our logo there. Now, the question is, what do we attach it to? Because... you know, what's something that is an add-on that you'll put on that you can include this with? Is your truck always going to have an exhaust? Is it always going to have, I mean, obviously it's always going to have an exhaust, but is it going to have a specific type of exhaust? Is it going to have, you can add it to really anything you want, but, I would probably add it to mirrors because it's like one of two types of mirrors in this on this particular truck. But like I said, you can add it to kind of whatever thing that you want. Side flares, sunshield, top flares. But we're going to go with mirrors because I feel like, you know, you're usually with your truck, you're going to pick one type of mirror. It's going to either be the standard one or the one with the lower wide-angle circle one. So in that case, what we're going to do right now is we're going to import the mirrors. So we're going to set our cursor to the mirror selector. So what we're going to do now is we're going to import, again going to the Kenworth W900. We already have the base in there. Okay. And then we're going to go upgrade mirror. So it's either going to be two or one. I think two is the double mirrors. It is. So in this case, if you want the double mirrors on your truck, what you can do is you can take these two things. Let's go here. We're going to call this mirror mirror 2L, or I could just erase it. That would be helpful. Mirror 2L. and we got everything we need there. We just need to add these guys. So what I'm going to do is going to take this plane and I'm going to set the origin to the 3D cursor. Set this origin to the 3D cursor. Hold shift, drop it in. Hold shift, drop it in. So now those are attached to this thing called Mirror2L. So if we go into plane, we see that we have all of this. I'm gonna actually change the specular value because that's probably gonna be too high and it'll be really shiny. So we don't want that. Let's change the shininess to like 80. Diffuse should be fine because it's black. And that's all the same because it's the same material, so that's good. All right. So now all we have to do is select, make sure that we have selected the correct export location for this. In this case, it's going to be vehicle truck upgrade mirror Kenworth W900. Select that. It's going to show up there. It's all default parts and variants, so you don't have to worry about putting it under a certain thing because this is just one type of mirror. No surprises. And then we're going to export it to that folder. Oh, we didn't normalize. Oh, those are, that's fine. Never mind. That's part of the existing truck. Okay. And that is how you do that. Now let's look at the packaging operation. We're going to clean the conversion tools. Technically, I don't need anything in here. The only thing I need is this TOBJ and the TGA. All the rest of this I can delete. That's the shared stuff. We can leave that for now. I don't need mirror 02. And I don't need WPass. So now what I can do is I can export this here, which is basically going to export the mirror. So now if I do new folder, we can look in our RSRC folder, linked cache, and we'll find what we made here, the TGA and the, well, now a DDS and the TOBJ, and then the upgraded mirror, which is right there. So we're going to take all these things minus the share and the automat. So we're going to take automat and vehicle, copy those, go back to our test folder, put them in the W900 dot door logo, not the expanded one that I just made, paste. Then you're going to go ahead and jump into the expanded SCS files because you're going to need to find something. You need to find the mirror accessory in here, which is right here. So shape 2, I think, is mirror 2. Yes, it is. Which one's shape 1? Yeah, that's the duty one. Okay. So shape 2. Did I open shape 1 again? What? There we go. Shape 2. So that's the one we want. So we're going to do copy. And then we're going to go back and we're going to make our folder directory here. So def vehicle truck. Upgrade. Mirror. I'm going to double check because I think it's mirror, not mirrors. Def vehicle truck. Whoops. Def vehicle truck accessory. I'm getting rusty. Def vehicle truck Kenworth dot W900 accessory mirror paste. We're going to call this shape2L. Then we're going to open this. We're going to make this shape2L. Standard with logo. 2L. Now the interior can stay the same because the logo will not be visible from the interior. So there's no point in making a new one for that. Don't need to do it. Okay. So we've got that sorted. I'm going to go back and make sure again that I've put it in the right spot. Def vehicle truck Kenworth W900 accessory mirror. Cool. So now all that's left to do is take this. Zip it up. You can leave it as a zip. You can change it to an SCS, whatever you'd like to do. Copy, documents, American Truck Simulator, mod, paste. Let's see if it worked. There's your door logo. So now if we go to truck dealer Kenworth, da da da. So now if I select the day cab, customize, I should find in the mirrors a standard with logo, and there you can see the logo is visible on the left and right sides. So what you can do now is you can take and make it red. You can do this one, you can change it to that, you can do this, you know, so any of these will work now, and you'll always have that logo there, you know, wherever you place it. Obviously it's a little different from side to side, so you'll have to do some more finagling than I did, but this is just for the basics. You can do anything you want with that logo when you select the diff spec over. So you can make multiple different positions of that everywhere you want. So you could make those all over the side of the truck if you wanted. Like for the sleeper, you could have specific ones for the sleeper where it shows your DOT reg and all that stuff. So just something to, little video to entice you to make yet another mod for yourself. Well, thanks for watching the video. I hope this helped you continue learning about modding and maybe adding something yet a little more different than other people. This is definitely a handy thing, and I want to thank the folks that wrote in to me via email to get me to do this video. This is actually something that you can do on any one of the trucks. adding it to the mirrors of any one of the trucks. I mean, you could create your own accessory node if you like, but this is a super easy way to do it, especially with something really small and easy to recreate like the mirrors. Nothing too extravagant there. Again, use that diff spec over value to have text or even an image with a transparent background, and then it will not hamper the rest of the skin that you're applying to the truck. So hope this helped you. I look forward to seeing what you do using this type of method. We'll see you for the next one. Bye-bye.